And this, the first meeting between these two countries, England and Argentina, since that infamous match in the World Cup quarterfinals in this stadium 8 years ago. Only one survivor from that match, and that's Perfumo, the Argentinian number two. Now the England side. And Joe Mercer, the caretaker manager, has made one or two changes from the side beaten by Scotland at Hampden Park on Saturday. The captain, Hughes, moves to number two in place of David Nish. In the side for the first time, his first international cap, Alec Lindsay, who only joined the squad from Liverpool on Monday. Also back, Kevin Keegan, his Liverpool clubmate. And at number 11, Trevor Brooking of West Ham, gaining his second international cap. Well, now from the England side to the Argentinians, who are on their way to the last 16 in the World Cup, and this part of their warm-up for the matches in Germany. And in fact, in this side, they've got the chance to play four players who normally play overseas. That's Cannavale, the goalkeeper, who plays for Las Palmas in Spain. Perfumo, the captain, who's with a Brazilian club. Also here, Ayala of Atletico Madrid. The stadium filling, and it certainly looks to be in the region of 50, 60,000 at least. And so it will be the Argentinians kicking off, playing from right to left in their famous national colours, blue and white stripes, for those of you not watching in colour, and black shorts. Saar, the captain. Perfumo, rather, the captain. Now Hughes, the English captain. England looking for some respectability after being beaten so emphatically by Scotland last week. That was a beautiful ball, and offside given. Keegan offside. No wonder he applauded the ball, though. It's Brindisi. A lot of skill in this Argentinian side. I watched them training yesterday morning. Full of ball players. It's Brooking now for England. Number 10, Weller. Picked out Colin Bell, but he couldn't find him. This is Telsch. Number 8, Brindisi. Tackled by Brooking, now Bell. This is Worthington. Number 8 for England. Channon. Offside again against Keegan. And England are prepared to come out and attack. That's two attacks by England in the first minute. Both offside. Brindisi in everything. Balbuena. Hughes for England. Channon. Brooking. Well cut out by Perfumo, but Worthington was offside anyway. These England forwards having great difficulty in remaining onside. The Argentinians are well organised at the back. Square. Ayala fouled by Watson. David Watson is third international. And it's Telsch with the kick to Vargas. Saar. Try to keep the ball in play, try to bend it. It's Todd for England. Watson. Todd to Lindsay. Worthington. Channon. Good tackle by Gloria. Now number 3, Lindsay for England. Bell. Trying to make space. And again offside. The crowd don't like these Argentinian tactics. It's the seventh time England have been caught offside in 16 minutes. Perfumo, the captain, to Telsch. Dizzy out to Saar. Vargas. Brindisi. Caught by Brooking, a foul. Free kick to Argentina. Argentinians, happy to knock it about. They play as if they've got all the time in the world. Complete belief in themselves. And DC to Balbuena, or Ayala rather. This is Balbuena. Got Telch available. Got Indici. Telch to Ayala. The orthodox cross. Shilton made it look very easy. Alec Benzo. Ready for movement up front. Channon's the one who's gone wide. There's Channon. Keegan. Argentinians pulling men back between ball and goal. Bell. And Weller just got offside. Vargas now to Saar. Brindisi they're finding all the time. Kempis. Foul by Hughes. And Hughes being told to calm it. But the way the Argentinians play, frustrating England. Hughes went in hard then and clearly was at fault. Hughes. Watson. Voila to Hughes. Again, the Argentinian defence pushing forward. Number 8, Channon won't make it. And England seem a little bit puzzled about what to do with this Argentinian defence. They're well organised with the captain, Perfumo, the number 2 centre-back. He directs all operations, and they keep compressing play in the middle of the field, pushing England forward, and they've caught England so often already. That's Perfumo, the architect of all at the back. This time he's got caught, it's Weller. Wide is Channon. And again offside, and that was doubtful. Five minutes gone. Still no score. And not offside this time. Channon. Yeah! Oh, and he didn't know anything about it. An astonishing save. It flew away from his hands and he actually knocked it away with his heels without knowing what day it was. That was Hughes. Weller. Wide Bell. Keegan couldn't get there. Wellington. Blarding away, and again it's not clear, and this time back safely to Carnevale, the crowd roaring, and that's one of the flukiest pieces of goalkeeping we'll ever see in international football. Just watch what happened, Channon from that angle, a tremendous drive, and it came back off the post onto his heel. It could have gone anywhere from there. Balbuena and Bell. Balbuena winning. Kempis rather. Squire couldn't win it. Well played by Tarda. Brooking to Hughes. England looking for a quick break, but the Argentinians with defence in depth still. Number 8, Channon. Brought down by Squire. Play waved on. Brooking now for England. Number 2, Hughes. That's Fern Lindsay, rather luckily. Brooking, and England had a genuine opportunity then. The ball found its way through to Lindsay, a deflection by an Argentinian defender. Lindsay, once he got there, powered the drive of the goalkeeper who couldn't hold it. It came to Brooking, but the Argentinian defender was there as well. K. Todd for England. Brooking is coming more and more into this game. Shannon available on the right. Number 8. Got the beating of this back for speed. But the back. Well, the flag was up. The referee waved it away. Hughes now for England. And Shannon stayed off the field, says he won't be offside, but the attack breaks down. And a free kick to England just outside the area. Emlyn Hughes. He's obviously taken a note of the number of the man who caught him. Got a long, hard look. And this is a free kick for England in what's a dangerous position for the Argentinians. Coming up to half-time, there'll be no injury time. Carnevale happy with the wall, and he's got 5 in it. In fact, he's got 6 in it now. They're still not 10 yards away. The ball with Keith Weller. Oh, it was nowhere near finding Watson on the left, but this time they have found Watson. The defence pushing out. Bell, who's found room. On for number 8, Shannon, and this is the first goal! And the Argentinians were found out. Bell looked up, the defence had pushed forward. Shannon's timing was perfect, his brain was cool, and he snipped through for the easiest of goals. Fine piece of play by Shannon, who kept his head, beat the offside trap, and now the Argentinians go back into the dressing room with the half-time whistle blown, 1-0 behind. England playing now from right to left in the second half, and in fact, Gloria is not on the field for the start of this second half. He's been substituted by Wolf. Wolf, who's the captain of the squad, or was the Argentinian captain of the squad. Tonight's team captain, of course, by Perfuma. Well, an hour for England. Number 10, Square. Ayala. This is Wolf. Valbuena. Forward ball for Brindisi. Lindsay cut it out. Todd now to number 7, Keegan. Good ball to Shannon, but he couldn't take it. Saar beat him. Emlyn Hughes, who showed signs of getting a little bit irritable and frustrated in the first half. As captain, of course, it's up to him to set an example. Keegan for England. Too long. Carnevale to Wolf. Wolf from the River Plate Club. Valbuena. Dizzy looking to Squeo. Wolf. Valbuena on to Wolf. Good running by the fullback. Out of play. In fact, in attack, the Argentinians have shown us very little indeed. It's Watson to Shilton. But as England know from previous encounters with Latin Europeans and South Americans, they only need to see the side of the goals and they're usually pretty deadly. Long kick by Shilton. By Vargas. Voila. Squeo. Brooking fighting for it. Hughes. Hughes made that his. Voila. Brooking. Keegan to Brooking. Telch. waved on. Valbuena. Argentinian still content to probe away. Squayo. Kempis. Wolf. Bell. England seeking to build quickly. Now Brooking. And Worthington's onside. Well killed. Corner. Nice piece of play by Frank Worthington. Interesting to watch this ball too from Worthington to his club captain Weller, and see here where the Weller was pushed. He was nowhere near the ball. It surely had to be a penalty. That's Bell. Worthington. Goal. Before Carnevale could begin to breathe again. Kempis. Ayala. Wonderful change of pace. Good a ball too. And Shilton, one hand, and following up was Kempis. And Shilton clapped his hands then. Stuck back in the net. And this was all made by the change of pace by this man Ayala. And he had time to look up, having left Watson. Shilton could only knock it away, and Kempis into the empty net. 2-1 with 13 minutes of the second half gone. Channon. Forced to carry the ball. Worthington. Tried the 1-2, didn't come off. Nice play by Vargas. Boyo to Telch. Wolf. Valbuena. Telch. Hausmann. Kempis. And Watson covered. David Watson filling in for Roy McFarlane tonight, effectively. Kempis with the call. One by Watson. Squayo, right through the line. Alec Linton. Number six, Bell. 3 minutes left for the Argentinians to save this game. Bell for England. Keegan. England lead 2-1. Couldn't find Bell. Now it's Telch for Argentina. Ayala. Todd with him. And Todd penalised. Well, I gave the ball then to the defender to pick up a player. And they took the free kick rather. That's Ayala. Watson in a tangle, but it was good enough. Todd to Shilton. Vargas backing up Channon. Keegan. Worthington now. Worthington offside. Channon got chopped in the meantime. Channon just picking himself up as the Argentinians come back. 2 minutes to go. Valbuena. Hausmann. Wide is Kempis, he's left. Oh, and he's taken a long time. Penalty! The referee had no hesitation whatsoever. Lucas had got a lot of space and then was brought down by Emlyn Hughes. So a chance now with less than 2 minutes to go for the Argentinians to draw them. Kempes placing the ball, and it's now Kempes versus Shilton. No chance, 2-2. Kempes' second goal, and Shilton was left without a hope. Right in the corner, hard and low, England 2, Argentina 2. And they've now played 90 minutes. England's disgust showing. A match England have always really been winning and now only drawing. Lindsay. Hughes. Bell, Keegan and Perfumo, and again, free kick given, no, a throw, referee indicates a throw, and he's saying no to Keegan, and the place lining up with the crowd now, as Brookie tries to get the ball back, and does. One or two spectators now beginning to demonstrate as one being hustled away down one of the exits. Sar for Argentina. And the whistle will go for time at any moment. There's not very much injury time. They played nearly a minute. Lindsay. Wolf. Houseman. Caught by Lindsay. And the whistle has gone. The spectators thought it was not the final whistle. I didn't either, actually. I thought it was a foul. And so the final whistle goes to boos from every corner of this stadium. Well, Argentina go to the World Cup, England don't. But for some of these England players tonight, a piece of international education. Because they've got to learn to live with this sort of treatment.